the US plays a completely disproportionate role in knowledge production and dissemination. But within the US, we know that there are serious inequalities too. And we have urban and rural divides in most countries. Even in the Indias and the South Africas of this world, those kind of Gini coefficients are really serious considerations. And the open access movement and the open source movement has taken on the issue of access in a really big way. And it's fantastic. It's really exciting. What's going on in open access is really exciting. The problem with open access, which I think open source differentiates and does a really good job of, is that difference between access and participation. So the open access movement has really been about, and you can look at Jimmy Wales talking about Wikipedia. He says access to human knowledge. And the scary thing is, whose human knowledge is he talking about? Everybody should be able to get to some of the stuff, but who's going to make the stuff? And that's what's so exciting about the open source movement and about open source communities, that it's not just about getting it, it's about making it. And it's about participation. And it's really exciting to see the kinds of studies that have been done that show that there is participation possible across countries. If you equalize for internet access and GDP, that is a real inclusive participation in ways that I don't know happen anywhere else. So I think that's the exciting part, and that's the equalizing part of open source. It's not necessarily cheaper. So this kind of notion of saving money is a dangerous one. It's more about what you invest your money in. You can invest your money in a license that's going to make a global company, and I'm not even going to say a US company, because global companies are not, you know, as we know, they're multinational. It's going to make shareholders for a company rich. Or you can invest that money in capacity building and in growing talent and in growing the ability to develop and to make and to create. And that's the value proposition for me around open source and why it's a great equalizer. In the case of the Sakai Consortium and now the Aperio Foundation, when we were looking for a way into the learning management system, and we're talking quite a long time ago, some of these words didn't exist, the way to go would be to partner with like-minded groups. And you know, you find them everywhere in the world. And you want to partner with people who will treat you as a partner. This is about relationships, this is about trust, this is about all those soft things that people don't necessarily feel comfortable with. But it's really important, because nobody likes to be on the receiving end of charity. And I think that what's really worked for us has been that it's a real set of partnerships. The fabulous thing about being involved in open source development is that people get to learn themselves. They are not just implementing an out-the-box solution, which is actually fundamentally quite boring. They are pushed. They have a chance to innovate themselves. They interpret. They contribute. They grow. In our case, we haven't always been able to keep them, but that's okay. I think that if you grow people to the point that they go better places for them and they contribute to the broader higher education community, I'm good with that.